Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in Texas, and we're running out of time for the boxes to send to the orphanage and stuff, guys. And Sister Pearlie had taken pictures of the stuff because I haven't had a chance to get up there to Chicago. So I'm trying to, save time and make a picture, show the pictures of the stuff people sent. What we need is we have the, it cost about $90 to $100 for each box, to say $100. For each box, big box that we can send to the Philippines. And we have lots of stuff. I think we have enough for about four or five boxes. So we have the funds for two boxes so far. So really need about, say, $300 more or so. Maybe it's even $400. And I don't know if I'm trying to get this thing to show up to change the pictures. It's not doing it for me. Sorry, guys. There it is. There's my little controller. There it is. So here's the stuff that people sent. It's just stuff, and I'm making the pictures just so anybody that wants to see and the people that sent them. And keeps going back to a small picture, guys. There it is. Stuff sent, people sent. We have lots of things that people sent, and I got the pictures. Maybe I've got two of some of the pictures, so sorry if I do. And one of them, she got the names back, maybe mixed up on one of them. I can't remember which one. If she put your name on the stuff or somebody else's stuff, sorry about that. It was one she got the names backwards. I can't remember which photo she told me, guys. All those little details of the thing is what will keep you all tied up if you get, down to every little detail. So here's the stuff somebody sent. All kinds of stuff. Shoes, toys, clothes, Bibles. Thank you to all the people that sent. And I think the Lord really the most maybe in this situation is for Sister Pearlie, because she's paying at her own self for two boxes, and she's the one that's collecting all the stuff, putting it together, getting the boxes, and all that hard work. So I ask you guys who have her, to thank her if you have not thanked her. And then I think this is all the pictures I have. If this is not all the pictures I have, I'm sorry. Let me get this thing. I'm trying to close it down. Okay. Guys, this is what it's all about. We have the feeding programs, the orphanage, and these kids there at the orphanage. This is a Sunday morning. Some neighborhood kids come also, and then we're doing a feeding afterwards. All of these kids right here, the orphans and stuff, and then those kids, we've already given them some clothes. But there's tons of places we do the feedings where the kids don't really have hardly any clothes. This is the orphanage. So our primary place to make sure we got everything they need is the orphanage, of course. Secondarily, whatever's left over, we're going to give out to the feeding. This is some, excuse me, food. This is called Big Knit, and it's very delicious. Lots of fruit, heart of the palm, bananas. There's different kinds of bananas, and these are the kind that you cook. There's 100 different kinds of bananas in the Philippines, and they're very delicious, different kinds. Some you have to cook. Some you eat off the tree, like the ones we have in the States. And this is just some feeding that we did after the Sunday service there in the orphanage. So, and I'm just showing this so you'll see what it's all about. I don't know if I showed these some of these pictures already. I did a report the other day. As you can see, these kids, lots of these kids don't even have shoes and stuff. You know what I mean? Or their shoes are worn out, tore up, hand me down, and falling apart. And these kids don't even really have hardly anything to wear. They wear their best clothes when they come to this thing, so this is the best they've got. And the clothes and stuff that people sent, all the stuff will be used. This is just one group of feeding out of six or seven of feedings. And every one of these kids can use some clothes. Every one of these kids can use school supplies. Every one of these families, would give a Bible. I'd like to give a nice these children's Bibles, at least one to each feeding program, to the pastors, and let them, the young people from the church read out of the Bibles and stuff. We already have some. We have lots of stuff. We can use more. These are some of our part-time orphans. These are a sister and two brothers, and they're part-time orphans. There's some things I've been studying that's stuck in there. Something I'm studying about the two Babylons. Someone did a whole thing comparing American symbolism to Babylonian symbolism. That's a whole different thing that I try to look at. This is a different feeding one, maybe. Some of the feeding programs, this one of the young people, she's trying to teach the kids. Lots of these kids, you see this kid doesn't have a shirt. I mean, you know. We could sure use your help with the feeding program, with the boxes. At this time, what I'm trying to do is get the money for boxes. So like I said, I need about $300, let's just say. And I think that will get us where we want to go. And I don't know if I've already see this. These are this is a different feeding program. I have so many different ones. Some of them is in a remote area and the pastors don't have the knowledge to operate a camera and upload pictures and all that. So some of the feeding programs don't do pictures. I only do pictures with the ones that are close enough to a town where they have the internet. They go to an internet cafe. You know, it's like 50 cents an hour or a dollar an hour. I take it back, like a dollar an hour to go online, and then they can load the photos and stuff. And, you know, so the really remote places, the people are even more poor, but I don't really have pictures of that unless I go there myself and do it. Anyway, guys, I appreciate your help. I ask you to pray about it. You can send to PayPal. I have my PayPal link. You can send to me. I'm going to, you know, send a whole, if I have to Western Union, I haven't talked to Sister Pearlie on the phone yet. I've been meaning to. We've just been messaging back and forth. I will transfer money to her, either if she has PayPal. I will send her a bulk, you know, $300 or $400 if that's what we need from the ministry for the boxes and everything as needed. I'm just trying to show these pictures. If I just showed these, I'm not sure. Maybe I didn't. Anyway, guys, if you could donate through the PayPal, my PayPal link is below here. It's neartochrist@aol.com. This is for America. The PayPal that's on my YouTube link and then on the website, joshuasministry.com, is goes to the Philippines directly. So this is for use here so we can send the boxes to the Philippines. We can get them there by Christmas. So that's why our deadline is really October 1st, maybe plus or minus a few days because we're almost to the 1st of October. Can get them there by Christmas. It takes a good 2 months. So that's why we said October 1st. Maybe if we send it by October the 5th or 6th, you know, 1 week more, could still get there by Christmas. You know, Sister Pearlie will be the one to be the expert on that by talking to the delivery company. So it depends on them, you know, when the ship will go out. You know, there's schedules of ships when they go out. And if the ship's going out at the right time, it can get there in less than 2 months, right at 2 months. If you have to wait on a ship, then it takes a long time. So, you know, it depends on how it goes. Anyway, guys, so something else I wanted to mention because I keep going on and on about this. I will be in Houston. For those who live in Houston, I'll put this in the title of this also. This coming Saturday, 2 p.m., we will meet at the Olive Garden in Woodland. So if you want to meet us there in Woodland, north of Houston, at the Olive Garden, message me and I'll give you the exact address and all that. Meet there at 2 o'clock this coming Saturday. We will be talking about end times and about all those kind of things, about the Joshua's ministry, about the orphanage, anything like that. I made a couple videos and I didn't post them. There's people that wanted to meet me and talk to me about all kinds of stuff that had nothing to do with the Lord, nothing to do with the ministry, nothing to do with God. And I would just say, I want to meet people that want to talk about the orphanage or about the feeding programs or about the end times or about the book that I wrote, which is the message of revival. I want to talk about revival, things of God, anything to do with the Lord, the ministry, and all that kind of stuff. I'll be glad to meet you there. So just message me, and I'll give you the address, and you can meet us there. That's this coming Saturday, whatever day that is. I think that's like the 26th, 27th, whatever it is, 28th of September, 2 o'clock at the Olive Garden in Woodland, Texas. The next Saturday, I'm planning on being in Dallas. I think that's October the 5th. Anyone in the Dallas area, message me. We'll set a location south of the city along Interstate 45. Somewhere south of the city, say 30 minutes. So, because I've got like a 4-hour drive up there from here. So, we can just move it down a little ways and kind of make it like we're meeting in the middle somewhere there. People from Dallas, even Austin, anywhere in this area that you want to come along that area. I can also schedule the next week maybe to be in San Antonio or Austin if enough people contact me. So, contact me. This coming week, the 28th of September, Houston, Woodlawn. Place is near north of Houston, Olive Garden, 2 o'clock. The next Saturday, which I believe is October the 5th, Dallas area, or just south of Dallas. Contact me and let's set a location. Then the next week, I will go if people ask me or if the Lord leads me, Austin or San Antonio area, or in between those places, maybe. A central location we can meet and talk end times, talk the Word of God. Be glad to meet you guys. I'm just flipping through these pictures and trying to talk about this other topic. I guess it's maximizing my multitasking ability here. So you see that they're using these coconut shells there to cook with, I guess. Sometimes they do. They use scrap wood. Oh, it's a banana tree there they're using to set it up on. It's old scrap wood. They just go around and collect it, you know. That's why lots of the people there don't really have jobs and stuff, because when you live in a tropical place, you can get by on all the stuff around. Most of these people, their parents are tenant farmers on some rich person's coconut farm or mango tree farm or banana farm, and then they just pick up the scrap woods and cook, and they grow a little bit of vegetables around their house. You know, that you can grow vegetables here 365 days a year. There's no winter time in the Philippines. So that's why lots of them have no ambition to do any better, the adults, because, well, they're not Christians. They're drunk. Most of the men are drunks. Say they have about an 80 or 90% alcoholism rate. And then they just sit around. They make homemade wine from the coconut sap. You go up to a coconut tree and you climb up in it and you get you a container to catch it, and you just keep scraping the coconut blossoms where it's about to make a new coconut, and you just let it drip into a container, and then you let it ferment, and then you got free coconut wine off of these trees. And then as they stay drunk on that all the time, and then they got that free firewood laying around, and then they grow a little bit of vegetables, and maybe the owner of the land gets them to raise a pig, and then they'll eat the pig for Christmas or something, and then they give the workers the heart, the lungs, the kidneys, and all that, whatever, the pig, and then they live off of that. And then they're just satisfied with their life, and then it just perpetuates lots of kids, no money, and alcoholism. And, you know, that's why we're trying to bring the gospel to the kids, to try to let them lead their families to the Lord. Let a little child lead them is the motto of Joshua's ministry that the Lord gave me. So we let the little children, you know, lead their parents to the Lord and be like Joshua in the Bible, who led his people into the promised land. Let their children lead their families into the promised land. I don't know how many more pictures I've got, if we've looked at all of them or what. But I've got tons. I'm just trying to fill that up. Well, these are some older pictures of the orphans, maybe from a few months ago. Earl there with the chickens. That's his thing, is to feed the chickens. They all have their chores. There they are. These are older pictures. I think I may have shown these in a slideshow or something before. There's Earl doing his chores, feeding the chickens. Or Daryl. This is Earl. I'm losing my mind. This is John Ray. That's John Ray. That's Earl feeding the chickens. That's John Ray getting ready to go to school. I've been gone already in a few months. Ronillo. He's riding a bike, as you can see. There's the chicken, mama chicken with her babies. We got like 100 chickens now, enough for them to make chicken soup at least once a week or twice a week, and then make a roasted chicken. There's the kids there, and by the grace of God, we've been trying to add more children, but the families, the relatives of the children, try to sell them to us, which is really bizarre, really weird. And they want a bribe or something to be paid off to let their, you know, niece or nephew or cousin, whatever, their parents are dead, let them stay in the orphanage. Isn't that sick? So we're not paying anybody money to let their kids stay in the orphanage. So we still keep looking as the Lord would open the door for kids to stay. Even these kids, their relatives try to do that, some of them. Even like Joni, her relatives try to do that. This is the floor. This is when we first finished up the flooring in the orphanage and all that. Maybe some of people are new and never saw this before. This is when the orphanage was first completed, basically completed. There they are at a Bible study again. This is the people there. So God bless you guys. I'm running out of time. I'm just filling it up while I'm making the video, making it 15 minutes long. And God bless you guys. And I appreciate any help that you would give toward the boxes, any help you would give toward the orphanage. If you want to send money for the orphanage, you can send it to the PayPal link that's on my YouTube channel where it says donate. That will go to Brother Martin in Australia and McCourt. And then Brother Martin will forward that there to me in the Philippines. And then I have it already set up to distribute that. You know, I have a treasurer there now while I'm gone to distribute that. My sister-in-law is the treasurer, and she will distribute it to the orphanage, the feedings, and all that stuff. So it's been, you know, it's going on.